Aditya, welcome to the mock interview today.
Thank you, sir.
So, Aditya, we would request you to tell us about yourself very briefly, your academic qualifications, your work experience, if any, and your main hobbies.
Sir, I did my bachelor's in information technology. And after that, I worked with IBM for 1.5 years in Bengaluru. And sir, currently I am serving as deputy collector in Oraya with Uttar Pradesh government since April 2021. And during my tenure, sir, I am serving as nodal officer for integrated COVID control and command center. My hobbies are doing meditation and writing a diary, sir.
Okay, so Aditya, that means you had appeared in UP civil services?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So which year did you appear and join?
Sir, I have appeared in 2018, but final result was announced in September 2020. I have joined in April
2021. Oh, so you have joined just 2 months before?
Yes, sir.
All right. So where are you posted, Aditya?
Sir, I am currently posted in Oraya district.
Okay, Oraya. And you said that you were handling, you were put in the COVID duty for some time.
Yes, sir. Currently, I'm serving as nodal officer for integrated COVID control and command center.
Oh, excellent. So tell me, yesterday I saw news that the Honorable Chief Minister of UP has said that we will face the third wave, in a better manner. So I just want to ask you from your experience as the nodal officer of whatever integrated center, that what went wrong in second wave and what are the arrangements or steps that you are taking or your administration is taking to deal with the third wave?
Sir, in my personal opinion, there were certain things which we have faced first time during second wave. Firstly, the rate at which COVID cases increased. Secondly, its reach. It even reached to our rural areas. And thirdly, sir, there was a demand supply mismatch when it came to oxygen supply or availability of healthcare facilities like beds, ICUs. So we were not able to anticipate the kind of its nature during second wave. But after the lessons we have got from this wave, we started preparing in advance for third wave. Like sir, we already started some pediatric centers. We hired medical professionals for dealing with this. Even for oxygen things, we are establishing plants in government hospitals as well as private hospitals. Thirdly, sir, people are more aware about COVID now. So it is easy to ensure COVID appropriate behavior. And sir, fourthly, we are also going for vaccination drive. Even we have started initial vaccination so that in case our children get affected in third wave, we have better preparation.
So, you mean to say anticipation, you said we could not anticipate. So, but we saw, the entire Europe, including United Kingdom, infested with the second wave. And we also knew sometime in November, December, how it is, skyrocketed and had gone to a very high level. And then it fell down also. So you think that it was, it was a issue of wisdom, or maybe we were slack about, not being, we were very, complacent that nothing will happen. What was the general, in the machinery, what was the feeling?
Sir, machinery was active. We have taken various initiatives, even after first wave. But problem is that, sir, we have lowered our guards against second wave, especially after January when cases started decline. And that thing is more from the public, that we started putting down our mask, even participating in social gathering, and that helped coronavirus to reach to larger areas, new variants coming and spreading to new areas. So it's more from our social behavior that impacted our preparation.
So Aditya, you are from Muzaffar Nagar, as I saw from your DAF, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So tell me one or two good things about Muzaffar Nagar and one or two not so good things about Muzaffar Nagar.
Sir, first good thing which I have realized about Muzaffar Nagar is a social harmony. The way people live and how their life is interlinked. So for example, even in my village, there is a dargah, which is visited by the people from all faiths and religions. Second is, it is famous for sugarcane production. So jaggery is very famous. And sir, if we talk about some negative things or some challenges, I would say challenges, then post 2013, there are few pockets, especially in city, there are still some tensions between communities. And secondly, even after having a geographical advantage, demographic advantage, we are still not able to reap that advantage completely.
So you said social harmony, maybe you did not mean communal harmony also. Muzaffar Nagar, I think, is one of the very few places which has seen communal riot in the last, you know, maybe a decade or 7-8 years. So tell me, it happened sometime in 2013-14?
Sorry, in 2013.
So tell me, my question basically is that you are an IT, you know, expert, and you are also deputy collector. Maybe you get into the service and you will become collector also. So in that case, tell me, how would you use your information technology knowledge when a communal riot takes place?
Sir, I have observed in Muzaffar Nagar as well as in Bangalore during Kaveri dispute in 2016 that during communal riots, two things are played very important role. First, communication gap leading to spread of false rumors. And secondly, kind of distrust among the public. And technology can help us in addressing both the things. So for example, we can make use of social media platforms like Facebook, WhatsApp, Twitter to counter rumors and to interact directly with the public by having helpline numbers, real-time communication. Secondly, we can also use these platforms to monitor activities and also to have intelligence at the ground level. Thirdly, sir, personally, I feel that if we have some kind of platforms where our officials can interact with the public at the ground, like members of peace committees, different religious leaders, panchayat members, it can help in addressing these counters, in restoring faith in the administration in real time. So I would like to work on these areas, sir. Okay.
So, Aditya, there is Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs. Have you heard about it?
Yes, sir.
Can you just briefly tell how has India's performance been over the last, say, almost 10 years since the SDGs were, or maybe 6 years? So how have we performed on all the 17 SDGs so far? And then I'll come to my next question.
Sir, in 2015, we moved from MDG to SDGs. We have achieved MDGs even before time. And when we comes to SDGs, then for overall SDGs, we are performing well at international level. At national level, there is no uniformity when it comes to states. Some states are going to achieve their targets before the deadline, like Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Himachal Pradesh. Find some states are trying to achieve their target. So for example, as a country, we have performed very good on front of reducing poverty. Like we help around 270 million people since 2000 to come out from poverty trap. In health sectors, we have reduced IMR, MMR even we come out with schemes like Ayushman Bharat, even on education front, sir, our literacy rate is rising. And from quantitative, we are also moving towards qualitative aspect, like we come with national education policy. Similarly, sir, with respect to smart cities, work culture, promoting equality among all the genders, and promoting sustainability, we are going on the right path, sir.
Okay. So, you mentioned about Kerala doing very well.
Yes, sir.
So, maybe this was in reference to Sustainable Development Goals Index. Did you mention this?
Yes, sir.
So, tell me, UP is not one of the front runners in the SDI index, which has been released by whom?
Niti Aayog, sir. By Niti Aayog.
So, why is Kerala high and why is UP not so high? What are the issues because of which UP could not be the front runner?
So there were various challenges in past which has impacted Uttar Pradesh growth and performance in various sectors, which ranges from its dependency on weather when it comes to agriculture, large population base. Thirdly, some natural calamities, especially in eastern parts of Uttar Pradesh, like floods, and also some structural issues when it comes to institutions facilitating peoples to build their capacities. But sir, in past few years, there is lots of improvement in Uttar Pradesh, and it is even highlighted by various reports. So, for example, as per Center for Monitoring Indian Economy, Uttar Pradesh has around 6% unemployment rate in May, even during COVID pandemic. Even when it comes to gross state domestic product, Uttar Pradesh became second highest GSDP state in our country. And so for improving education, health, there are various initiatives have been taken and which will definitely show their results in coming years.
So, Aditya, I now pass on to Mr. Khanna. He will interact with you.
Thank you, sir.
Good morning, Aditya.
Good morning, sir.
How does it feel like clearing the mains and now preparing for the interview?
Sir, I am feeling very good because it's going to be my third interview. So, I am going... I'm working on some mistakes I have did in past and looking for better performance this time.
So can you tell me what was your score in the earlier two interviews?
Sir, in first interview, I got 135 in 2018. And in last interview, I scored 157, sir.
And there's going to be the third one?
Yes, sir.
All right. So I'm sure you would have prepared well this time. I find from your dev that you have appeared for defense services, armed forces, civil services, forest service, so many different types of examinations. So what exactly is your aim in life? Whatever you get, does it mean that you will take that?
Sir, I was looking for a service which provides me leadership role and also opportunity to serve for my country and for the society. During my graduation, I decided to prepare for civil services. But at that time, there was also some financial issues in my family. So I was eligible. So I have appeared for various examinations like CTS and CPF during that time, sir.
Okay. So it was to overcome the financial issues. I didn't get your point. Financial issues. How you resolved your financial issues?
So
or you wanted to take up a job so that financial issues can be resolved?
There were both the things that on one hand, I was looking for jobs which provides me leadership role and all these jobs. Defense services through combined defense services, Army, Air Force, Navy, as well as CAPF. They also offers me this opportunity. And secondly, I was looking that if I get any opportunity, then at least I give some support to my family.
Okay. Okay. So you, yes, you talked of leadership. So what are qualities of a leader? Can you tell me your qualities as a leader and how will it help you in civil service?
Sir, for a leader, first ability is to make right decision at right time. Secondly, consultative in approach, that he should be accommodative to others' view and take decisions on his own wisdom. Thirdly, sir, accountability for his actions. And sir, fourthly is ability to converge capabilities and goals of others towards a common organizational or social roles.
Okay, and what do you see in civil service? Why civil service and not career in IT? You were working in IBM.
Yes, sir.
IBM is a fairly big, very big company.
Yes, sir.
It offers you a far better career prospect than maybe any other government job, financially.
Yes, I'm sir. Not
talking otherwise.
Sir, I opted for IBM, as I previously told that there were some financial issues. I opted as I got placement, I continued with my preparation. As when it comes to civil services, sir, it provides a platform where we can have leadership roles in diverse areas and we can deliver to the people to achieve their potentials, to improve their life. And sir, during my tenure of deputy collector, I have realized these things. Even in assisting someone. Yes.
Okay, you have done your graduation from APJ Abdul Kalam University.
Yes, sir.
APJ Abdul Kalam was very fond of PURA scheme. He always talked of PURA. What is this PURA scheme?
Sorry, sir, I am not able to recall, sir, exactly.
Okay, so read about PURA of Abdul Kalam. You are an IT graduate, so I want to know what is God's equation in mathematics. It is one of the most popular equations and people have started calling it God's equation. What is God's equation? I can give you a hint. Euler came out with this equation.
Sorry, sir, I don't know, sir.
What are the universal constants and what are their relevance and importance in science and IT, of course? Universal constants.
Sorry, sir, I am not able to recall.
Pi E, have you not heard of pi and e?
Yes, sir, I have heard about that.
So these are some of the well-known universal constants. And G.
Gravity.
All right.
Thank you.
Talking about vaccination policy, yesterday Supreme Court, two days back, Supreme Court criticized the government on vaccination policy. Now that you are already working in this, tell me how this policy will cater to the requirements of the rural population, rural India. How, when they do not have digital literacy, digital reach. So what should be done so that the policy is equally reaches to the rural areas?
Sir, as highlighted by Honorable Supreme Court and also as per my personal experience, in rural areas currently we are assisting public through common service centers to get registered on common portal. But still there is a scope of improvement when it comes to coverage by making it optional that who want to register through COVID, they continue with that. Otherwise people can come to the center and they can be registered on the spot. Secondly, sir, we can also have some mobile COVID vaccination centers, as we are doing in our district, that we are informing a particular village people that on that day we will establish this center so that they can come and have vaccination to increase this coverage. And sir, apart from this, sir, there is also vaccination hesitancy, which is playing a bigger role in affecting our vaccination coverage, apart from this digitization issue. So on that front also, we need to raise awareness and making accessible to the public availability of vaccine.
There is a growing concern about breach of security, especially cyber security in government offices. We have heard about breach of security in Air India. We have heard about breach of security in various government offices. So what are the reasons? Is our system so inefficient? And number one is what are the reasons, and how you think India should tackle the cyber security issue?
So, there are multiple reasons for these issues in the cyberspace. Firstly, when it comes to network, then we are not following policies like having firewalls in place, having antivirus installed in our system to scan our system. Secondly, we also knowingly or unknowingly download some pirated softwares or access some sites which also gets these virus enter into our system. And apart from that, sir, we have also issues with respect to coordination at national level between various agencies. And so fourthly, if we look at the ground level, then we have a lots of dependency when it comes to hardware on other countries or network equipment. So this is also very kind of vulnerability things for us in cyberspace. And sir, when it comes to solution, then firstly, at national level, we should have more cooperation and coordination between institutions like CERTIN and this NTRO and different institutional institutions. Secondly, there is also need of industry academia collaboration. So we have more cyber experts as envisaged by our cybersecurity policy. Thirdly, sir, we need to build our own capacity for meeting our requirements in hardwares and all other things. Fourthly, at ground level, there needs to be more awareness among the people about some appropriate cybersecurity policies. And sir,
just tell me, ethical hacking, should that be made a part of the government policy to safeguard against cyber threat?
Sir, ethical hacking has potential to assess our vulnerability, especially when it comes to government institution. So it can also play a very important role in building our resilience against such attacks or such incidents.
Okay. Yesterday, monetary policy, which talks about economy, Indian economy for the year 21-22. This shows that the impact of second wave has been very minimal on the economy. So what do you think should be the projection for the third wave? You think third wave is going to be more severe on the economy?
Sir, looking at our past experience and the way we have learned from first pandemic and improved on things during second pandemic, I am optimistic that during third wave, we will be in a better position to handle that and in ensuring a growing economy. And sir, we have learned various lessons, like localized lockdowns are more effective. So we can go for that during third wave. And thirdly, the way we have digitized our economy or going for digitization, that will also help in continuous growth even during third pandemic.
What is the projection for the economy in 21-22? Growth, GDP growth?
Sir, I'm not able to recall exactly, but okay. Different.
Sir. No, so you should read the newspaper even on the day of interview. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay.
All right. Last question before I pass on. This China's project of One Road, One Belt, OROB, what is its status today? Has the world realized that there is a hidden agenda? Or you think it is going to take shape as planned by China?
Sir, there is a mixed response from countries around the globe. Countries like European Union, USA, United States of America, India, Australia, they have realized that China has hidden intentions, as highlighted by its debt trap, or it is trying to make use of facilities in other countries for dual purpose. But for other countries, like in Southeast Asia, Central Asia, countries are going in the trap of China because they have no alternatives. Chinese growing economy and its capability in other areas, making countries to fall in this trap. So as countries, world countries are realizing its true nature, in future, it will be totally depend on global countries and institutions like Quad, whether China is going to achieve its objectives or there will be some kind of oppositions by other countries.
Okay, thank you. Over to you, Sumesh.
Okay, Mr. Aditya.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, yes. So continuing on some international affairs only, why do you see, what do you see importance of India becoming a UNSC permanent member?
Sir, firstly, it will make UNSC more inclusive by considering opinion and views of developing countries. Secondly, sir, it will also help in balancing decisions taken by UNSC, especially when it comes to issues like some regional conflicts or some human rights issues. And thirdly, sir, by having membership in UNSC, India can help or India can better serve to its national as well as regional and international interests.
Okay, fair enough. So I see your optional subject is geography.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so tell me the best ways to deal with natural disasters administratively.
Sir, there is a need for various steps or various things for building our capacity against natural disasters from administrative perspective. First is warning or information dissemination in advance through better surveillance center, monitoring center, coordination with agencies like IMD. Second is building capacity at ground level by raising awareness among the people, by activating district disaster management authorities and having assessment of their resources. Thirdly, building infrastructure for dealing with such calamities like shelters, like some emergency measures. And fourthly, a kind of emergency plan to activate all these resources for saving lives and property during such calamities.
Okay, so can you tell me the reasons behind the increasing frequency and intensity of cyclones?
So this increasing intensity and number of cyclones is mainly due to rising global temperature, especially on sea surface, which is making conditions conducive for low pressure and helping these cyclones to come on a regular basis. Secondly, sir, some atmospheric phenomena like La Nina, Al Nina, they have also implications on these atmospheric developments. Especially we have seen in the case of Tokte that last year La Nina favored this time this building up of Tokte.
Okay, Aditya, I pass on to Chairman, sir.
So, Aditya, you have heard about the Supreme Court making a, you know, very important statement with regard to sedition and freedom of speech and expression in some important case one or two days ago.
Yes, sir.
What is that? Then I'll ask what I have in mind.
Sir, Honorable Supreme Court gave its verdict in a case in which sedition charges was filed against journalist Vinod Dua. And Supreme Court observed that guidelines given by Supreme Court in Kedarnath case should be followed in its true spirit. And sedition under Section 124A of IPC should be used when there is a real threat to national security, public order, instead of making it used as a political tool for suppressing right to freedom of people.
So tell me, United Nations has also celebrated 75 years of its, you know, constitution. Now, tell me, all these 75 years, how do you feel that UN has been helpful in, number one, preventing wars or maybe mitigating, number two, controlling or preventing terrorism, and thirdly, in the COVID crisis?
Sir, over a period of 75 years, United Nations was successful on first parameter, that is, it was successful in avoiding Third World War, one serious conflict at international level, though there were some small conflicts at regional level. Secondly, with respect to terrorism, so United Nations, through passing various resolutions, formulating committees, they contributed in sanctioning some terrorist organizations and in stopping their funding. But at large, there is needs for more work, more initiative, because terrorism is growing at a very fast pace and it is now becoming an international problem. Thirdly, with respect to COVID pandemic, there could be more proactiveness shown by United Nations when it comes to COVID. Though United Nations ask countries to collaborate with each other to help developing countries, but still there could be more things which can be done, like some initial coordination, dialogues, equitable distribution of vaccines, which is not the case in present times, and also helping countries to ensure this demand supply chain.
Okay. So, Aditya, we have asked you quite a few questions. Any subject or topic which we may have left out, and you would like us to ask a question from that left out subject?
Sir, I have played volleyball, so I am interested in having a conversation on that, sir.
All right. So, volleyball is an interesting game. Doesn't require much of infrastructure. You just need to put a net in between and start playing anywhere, even on the beaches. Right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Even then, it has not become popular in India.
Yes, sir.
What do you think are the reasons?
Sir, there are multiple reasons for the volleyball not being a so popular game. First issue at ground level, that we are not able to recognize talent in early stage because of unavailability of infrastructure or platforms. Secondly, even players who plays volleyball, they find it difficult to adopt it as a career opportunity. So they shift to other professions. And third issue is with respect to management at Volleyball Federation of India level. In past, our team got banned from participating in World Championship because of some mismanagement practices. Our team not getting exposure to international events. Mm-hmm. Our team not getting kind of technical exposure. So all those things impacting our performance, which is impacting marketing and its popularity in our countries.
So Adit, we have finished our formal interview now.
So Adit, this is your third experience of interview. Two you have already appeared before UPSC and this mock. How you rate yourself as compared to the earlier two? And what you think were your own deficiencies? Your analysis first, then we'll tell you.
Sir, with respect to past two interviews, this interview is a little bit better, but there is a lot of scope of improvement. Sir, first, with respect to knowledge, especially to my IT field and schemes like Pura, you have asked. Second, with respect to delivery, that I could be more concise and clear in my answers. So on restructuring and framing, I need to work. And thirdly, sir, with respect to giving answers in a more holistic and to the point way.
All right, I think you have assessed yourself very well. You need to at least come out with your own subject. I asked you, they are so important. E and pi, I thought were the elementary things for a IT graduate. Then God's equation or Euler's equation. See this, there's very, very small things, but one expects a technical graduate, especially in IT, to know about it. Pura, since you have done from Abdul Kalam University, please go through all the important things about Abdul Kalam.
Okay, sir.
Okay. PURA was a scheme which was very close to his heart, providing urban infrastructure in rural areas. So then vaccination policy, you were fine, except that digital literacy and digital divide and the Government of India's policy that you have to register on the COVAX app, which may not be accessible to people in rural areas. So there has to be an answer to that. So some correction required by the government. OROB, you were fine. But for one little catch, that now countries have started realizing about the debt trap in which they are falling. So that could be one realization which has come a little late. Cybersecurity breach was good. MPC report, read newspaper even on the day of the interview. Now, leadership qualities, you didn't mention of integrity. Most important, other than, teamwork, other than various other qualities that you listed, please also see, because this is going to be crucial part of your discussion. Your personality wise, you have a pleasing personality. You were not very long, means at least in the questions that not very long except one question, but and you were confident. I could see that this time you are far more composed, confident, and you were taking questions. Even if you don't know, it is fine. Say that you are not able to either recall or you don't know.
Thank you, sir.
With all the positives your way, I'm sure you can do much better. Catch up with the current affairs, catch up with between the lines of the policies and your own subject. IT may anything from WhatsApp, Twitter issue to government's rules on the subject. And why Google is saying it should be excluded from the rules. Okay, over to you, Vinodji.
Thank you, sir.
So Aditya, a few points from my side as well. You are smart. You have a pleasant personality. You are quite at ease, comfortable. Your body language was also very positive. I would say that you were well informed as far as current affairs are concerned. what is happening around the world, you were able to answer, and you knew everything about, you know, what has happened even a day before, which is a very good thing. And the situational questions which I placed before you, you handled quite well, except that, you know, in the case of the communal rights question which I posed before you, your answer was not, you know, technically loaded, in the sense that you are an IT B.Tech. लेकिन आपका आंसर एक डिप्टी कलेक्टर वाला था, एक जर्नलिस्ट की तरह था. तो यही आपकी सबसे बड़ी कमी है आदित्य, कि आपका जो डैफ है उसमें आपने भले ही यू हैव डन योर बीटेक आईटी लॉन्ग गो, बट यू कांट हेल्प इट. यू नो, पैनल का इंटरव्यू बोर्ड की नजर पहुंचेगी पहुंचेगी उस. Then, so you have to, and rightly so, because you were not able to take those questions very well, which Khanna sahab had posed. I placed more of general questions, situational, how would you react? So that way, I mean, we found you pretty okay, except the case that I mentioned. There also, you, your knowledge about IT, your B.Tech, background, that is to be blamed, because you were not very well informed about, you know, the IT matters jo aapko hona chahiye tha. Aapko isliye jo DAF se related jitne issues hain aapne jo likhe hain, whether it is Muzaffarnagar, if you see, we asked you questions from UP, I asked you question from Muzaffarnagar. Then I asked you about your information technology. Khanna sahab asked you about your IT, you know, some basic issues. Also about why defense, why IFS, and then why IAS. So everything, you know, 50 to 60% cases, questions were related to that. So aapko usme bahut mahir hona hai. Wahin pe aap thoda sa bhi kami reh gayi aapki. Otherwise, you can communicate also well. And your subject knowledge needs to be brushed up. Communication mein maine dekha thoda sa smoothness nahi hai aapke baat cheet mein. Kuch to aaj audio ki problem rahi hai. To cut cut ki awaaz aa rahi thi, lekin main usko discount kar raha hoon. Main aapki pronunciations ki taraf dhyan dila raha hoon. Thoda sa English mein halka sa refinement laiye bol. रिहर्स कर करके.
ओके सर,
आपकी इंग्लिश सही है, ग्रामेटिकली सही है, कुछ बैकग्राउंड का है जो लोकल, आप यूपी में रहे हैं तो उसका असर होता है, यू नो, डिपेंड. आप विदेश में चले जाओ तो आप अमेरिकन, आपका एक्सेंट हो जाता है. थोड़े एक्सेंट में थोड़ा सा नॉर्मलाइज करिए एंड ब्रिंग सम, यू नो, गुड प्रोनंसिएशन, जिससे नॉर्मल होता है. यू डोंट हैव टू बी वेरी इंग्लिश लाइक, बट हल्का सा ऐसा लगा कि जैसे आप में थोड़ा रिफाइनमेंट की जरूरत है. आप जब जाएंगे इंटरव्यू के लिए तो गो इन अ प्रॉपर अटायर. आई थिंक यू विल नॉट वेयर दिस अ शर्ट लाइक दिस एंड यू नो यू विल गो विद जैकेट एंड टाई. पिछले इंटरव्यू में आप कैसे गए थे, क्या पहन के गए थे?
सर, सूट, वाइट शर्ट एंड नेवी ब्लू सूट.
गुड, सो यू शुड लुक स्मार्ट. यू आर हैंडसम, सो यू, if you put up a good attire, you know, काफी नंबर उसके मिलते हैं आदित्य, और उसके बाद जो आप बोलते हो उसके मिलते हैं, ठीक है ना? तो आप हंसते भी हो, आप कॉन्फिडेंट भी हो, you have a pleasant personality, interview board आपको देख के कोशिश करेगा और क्वेश्चन ज्यादा पूछने के. यू लुक ब्राइट फ्रॉम योर फेस एंड एक्सप्रेशन. सो बट उसके बाद अगर नहीं ब्राइटनेस निकली तो फिर वो उल्टा पड़ता है, ठीक है? You were able to answer, you know, all the questions related to your knowledge of current affairs and whatever. लेकिन आप थोड़ा सा ध्यान रखो, जो कैंडिडेट्स हैं आप जैसे, वो ये सोचते हैं कि अरे अब तो सब हो गया, मेन मेन भी हो गया, अब तो बस ये इधर उधर का पूछेंगे, अखबार में पूछ लेंगे, इकोनॉमी का पूछ लेंगे, यूएन का पूछ लेंगे, फॉरन अफेयर्स पूछ लेंगे, बट प्रॉब्लम ये है कि वो स्टार्ट ही आपके डेफ से ही होते हैं. सो डेफ को बिल्कुल घोंट लो आप और उसके एफएक्यूज बना लो.
ठीक है सर.
मतलब इट इज वेरी सिंपल. अब मुजफ्फरनगर को आप एक बार एक घंटा इसी पे चर्चा करो. मुजफ्फरनगर, अच्छा क्या हो सकता है मुजफ्फरनगर में? शुगर केन है मुजफ्फरनगर, वेस्टर्न यूपी है, थोड़ा ज्यादा डेवलप्ड है ईस्टर्न से, रॉयट्स के लिए फेमस है या हुआ था पिछले दिनों में, दिल्ली से पास है, यू नो पॉलिटिकली बड़ी स्टेबल स्ट्रॉन्ग रहा है. और कितने क्वेश्चन निकलेंगे मुजफ्फरनगर से, है ना? उसको लिख लो. आईटी में क्या हो रहा है दुनिया में, आईटी से रिलेटेड. दिस इज अ वेरी ब्रॉड एरिया जहाँ आपको थोड़ी तैयारी ज्यादा करनी पड़ेगी. वो आईटी सच अ बिग, बट आईटी को एज इट इज नहीं पूछेंगे कि अच्छा भाई डिफाइन इंफॉर्मेशन टेक्नोलॉजी इंडिया आईटी में कैसी है, है ना? आपका स्टेट आईटी में कैसा है, अपने काम में कैसे आईटी को अप्लाई करोगे विच आई ऑल्सो यूज. अब इट कुड बी कम्युनल रॉयट, इट कुड बी आई कुड हैव आस्क्ड यू अबाउट कोविड कि कोविड में आईटी कैसे यूज होगा, डिस्ट्रिक्ट एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन में कैसे होगा, लॉ एंड ऑर्डर में कैसे होगा. And since you are a deputy collector, you will certainly be asked at least one question about your COVID thing that you are doing. Usko bilkul tayari se jao.
Okay, sir.
You dealt the question very nicely. Thoda sa aur usme finesse jaise hota hai na, quality le aaiye. Aur points bana lijiye, rat lijiye unko. Aap kar rahe hain jo aap us samay aapko char main points batane hain. Aapke dimag mein बोलने को आप 10-20 भी बोल सकते हो, नॉलेज है आपके पास, लेकिन चार कौन से बोलने हैं? अब आपने कोविड की थर्ड वेव की बात करी तो आपने आगे पीछे किया, है ना? आपने ये माना अवेयरनेस तो हो ही गई है अब लोगों को. नाउ सबसे पहले अवेयरनेस आनी चाहिए, प्रिवेंटिव. प्रिवेंशन इज बेटर देन क्योर. हाउ वुड यू प्रिवेंट? ये सेकेंड वेव का ज्यादा इम्पैक्ट इसीलिए हुआ क्योंकि यू मेंशन लेटर ऑन कि दे लोअर द गार्ड. तो आपके थर्ड वेव हो चाहे फोर्थ वेव हो, अवेयरनेस तो हमेशा ही चलनी है आपके प्रशासन में कि भाइयों मत करो, भाइयों मत करो, भाइयों पहनो जो भी पहनना है. आप समझे ना, वो अभी भी करना पड़ेगा. लोग कितना ही डर लिए हों, कितना ही भुगत लिए हों, लेकिन वो आप देखिए अभी लॉकडाउन हटता है कैसे फिर वो शराब की दुकानों पर लाइनें लगेंगी. ठीक है ना? So, anything you want to know, Adit?
Sir, with respect to, sir, apart from this DEF preparation, because currently I'm not able to go through my DEF thoroughly because of lots of pressure during COVID. Sir, apart from that, with respect to delivery and with respect to the point or brevity in my answers, how would you assess and, sir, what...
Aditya, you were precise, and your content was good,
sir.
And you were abreast of the latest that is happening around. And even when I did not touch upon it, you mentioned, so I was very happy about this SDI index. You know, sir. Niti Aayog bhi aapko pata tha. So, ye sab cheezein aapke hisab se, everything else is fine.
Okay, sir.
और कुछ
नहीं,
पर आपको देखो पांच चीजें बतानी है लिमिटेड टाइम में, तो कौन सी पांच बतानी है भाई? आप लोग मेन एग्जाम में कर चुके हो भाई, हमारे टाइम से चला आ रहा है. हमें प्रॉब्लम ये होती थी कि इतने बड़े इशू को 100 वर्ड्स में, 120 वर्ड्स में कैसे लिखें मेन में, है कि नहीं? दिक्कत होती है
सर.
तो मेन में कुछ लिखा होगा अच्छा, तभी तो तुम क्लियर हो गए. कोई चीज यहाँ करनी है कि एक इशू को 120 वर्ड में आपने पॉइंट वाइज जो भी लिखा वहां, यहाँ पे आपको पॉइंट वाइज बताना है. तो जितने वर्ड्स वहां पे वर्ड्स कम थे, यहाँ पे टाइम कम है. ठीक है, प्रिसिशन भी, प्रिसाइज भी हो जाएगा, छोटा भी हो जाएगा और पंच आएगा. मतलब जो क्वालिटी, आपने 10 पॉइंट लिखे है, 10 तो नहीं बता पाओगे. आप देखते नहीं हो, अरे यार ये सेकेंड पॉइंट तो यूजलेस है, ये सिक्स्थ वाला पॉइंट मैं ऊपर ले आता हूँ. जहाँ ऑर्डर है वहाँ ऑर्डर से चलो. यू नो, आपकी माइंड की क्लैरिटी पता लगेगी, हैप्पी हैजर्ड नहीं. अच्छा, हम वैक्सीनेशन लगा लेंगे सर, फिर मैं ऐसा करूंगा कि एसएमएस से सबको इन्फॉर्म कर दूंगा, फिर थर्डली ऑक्सीजन भी कम होगी तो वो भी कर लूंगा. नाउ देयर इज नो कोरिलेशन, यू अंडरस्टैंड. स्टार्ट विद प्रिवेंशन. व्हाट ऑल विल यू डू फॉर प्रिवेंशन? देन इन केस समथिंग हैपेंस, देन यू नीड बेड्स, यू नीड डॉक्टर्स एंड हेल्थ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर, हेल्थ वर्कर्स, उसकी भी कमी होनी. देन यू नीड ऑक्सीजन, जब आईसीयू में जाएगा तो वो ऑक्सीजन लेगा. तो इससे ये पता लगता है ग्रेजुएट, और वैक्सीनेशन उससे पहले ही अवेयरनेस कि भाइयों बच के रहो, नंबर दो वैक्सीनेशन का इंतजाम करो, जब वैक्सीनेशन इंतजाम करो तो उनको अवेयर कराओ कि वैक्सीनेशन लो, उसके बाद अगर हो जाता है तो फिर आप ये करेंगे. हॉस्पिटल बेड्स भी हम साथ साथ बढ़ाएंगे, उसमें ऑक्सीजन भी करेंगे, घर के डोर टू डोर ट्रीटमेंट, डोर टू डोर सर्विस भी हम दे सकते हैं, मेडिसिन भी पहुंचा सकते हैं, कंट्रोल रूम भी बना सकते हैं, यू नो ऑल दीज थिंग्स. ओके
सर, आई विल वर्क ऑन दैट.
सो ऑल द बेस्ट आदित्य, डू वेल.
ऑल द बेस्ट आदित्य.
ऑल द बेस्ट आदित्य.
थैंक यू सर.